Greetings and welcome to Astronomy at Hack. In this video, I will walk through an example of how to calculate a scale model of the solar system. And essentially what I'll show you is how to do the calculations. And this will be useful for one of the lab activities that you'll be doing in terms of figuring out what calculating a sample scale model of the solar system. And perhaps if you're doing the discussion, we'll show you how to walk off at least the inner part of the solar system as you begin to see how large everything is and how difficult it would actually be to walk off an entire solar system. So let's get started here by looking at what we have. First of all, let's look at the distances of the planets. I have a table here which gives you the average distance in kilometers from the sun of each of the eight planets and the average distance in astronomical units. So this gives you some idea of the scale of how far away things are, that if the Earth is one unit away from the sun, then Jupiter is going to be five times as far away, Saturn about 10, Uranus 20, and Neptune 30. So if you do the Earth at 1 meter from the sun, then Neptune has to be 30 meters away. Now that isn't too bad to be able to do, although if you ever try to do a real scale model of the solar system, getting the sizes and distances correct, then it is very hard to do, because when you do this model, if you did this at a few meters, yes, you could fit that very easily. Outdoors be very easy to set up some model like that, but the sizes would all be way too small. It would all be minuscule and you wouldn't be able to see the difference in sizes. If you try to do one with sizes and distances, it is much more difficult. So let's look at a couple of examples and how you would go about calculating this scale model here. So first of all, we're going to look at the Earth-Moon system. I know I will ask you to do a calculation for the solar system and the distances, but here let's do the same thing and the calculations are exactly the same. You'd use the same style, just the numbers that have changed. So what we're going to look at here, we have to find some numbers. First of all, we have to know how big the Earth is in real life. So that is 12,750 kilometers. In our scale model, we're going to scale it down to 10 inches. Now we have to calculate a scale factor, and the scale factor is equal to the scaled diameter divided by the actual diameter. You're going to do the same thing for the sun. You're going to find the scale diameter. I give you that in the assignment in centimeters. And then you're going to look up the actual diameter. How big is the sun in kilometers? You divide those two and you will get your scale factor that you need. In this case, our scale factor, again, the scale diameter divided by the actual diameter is 10 inches divided by 12,750 kilometers and gives us a scale factor of 0.000784 inches per kilometer. So what we see, that is our scale factor. Now that will remain the same for anything we want to use for this. When you do this for the sun, you will keep that exact number. It will be a very small number. If you get a big number, then something is wrong. You did something backwards. The scale factor will be a very small number in terms of you'll have yours as some value of centimeters per kilometers in this, because I ask you to convert the sun to a certain size in centimeters. So you will use that, divide it by the actual size in kilometers, and that will get your scale factor, and you will use that for the remainder of the assignment. Now, once we find the scale factor, we can then use that to create our scale model. So what we have here is we want to look at how large is the moon going to be in this model. So how large, what is the size of the moon going to be? How big is it? And what we need in that case, we need the actual diameter of the moon. So we need to know how big the moon is in real life. We multiply it by that scale factor that we determined in the previous step. So we just multiply these two together. In this case, the moon's diameter is 3,740 kilometers. Our scale factor that was previously determined. And if we multiply those two, we'd find that to the scale, the moon would be 2.9 inches. So in our model here, the Earth is 10 inches and the moon is about 2.9 inches, significantly smaller than the Earth. So you can actually compare them. So in our scale model, you use that exact same scale factor. We determined it using the Earth. We can then apply it to the moon or to any other object in the solar system. If the Earth is a ball 10 inches in diameter, how big is any other object going to be? And you can calculate that using this exact same scale factor. That will be anything you'd use this would convert to an Earth model of 10 inches. Now we can also not only figure out the size, but we can figure out the distance. So let's look at the distance as well. What we have here, now how far from the Earth will the moon be? So we're looking for the distance, how far away it's going to be from the Earth. The calculation is exactly the same, except now we're looking for the distance of the moon. How far away is it? The scale factor is unchanged. You use that exact same scale factor every single time. And again, all you do is multiply the two. In this case, the moon is 384,000 kilometers away. Multiply that by the scale factor that we determined in our very first step here. And we would find that the Earth is 301 inches away from the moon, or about 25 feet. So in our scale model, the Earth is a ball that is 10 inches in diameter, and 25 feet away from that, you put a 3-inch ball, and that would represent the moon. So that would show our scale of the moon. And if you make a model like that, you can really get an idea of how empty the space between even the Earth and the moon is. There's very little space there, and there's very lot of space there compared to the sizes of the actual objects. Now, when you do this, what I ask you to do in your assignment, so in the activity that you're assigned, you get a value for the sun. So you'll have a given diameter of the sun in your project. You use that and you divide that by the sun's actual diameter. And that will give you the scale factor. So that will give you your scale factor. It will not be the same as the scale factor we used here. The given diameter is in centimeters. The actual diameter, look it up in kilometers. So your scale factor will have units of centimeters per kilometer. Then all you need to do for the assignment is to take that scale factor and multiply it by the distance of each planet from the sun. And that's all you're going to do. You can look up those values in your textbook. They will be millions of kilometers. In fact, I gave them to you in the very first slide here when we got started. All you do is multiply those by your determined scale factor to get them in centimeters. That will give you scaled sizes in centimeters. And then you have to convert those to meters for the assignment. And all you do is centimeters. And you divide those values by 100 will give you your final answer in meters. I will tell you that your answers for the scale factors I typically use should be some small number of meters. It will depend on the exact value I've given for this class, but it could be something like 5, 10, 20 meters. If you're getting values that are hundreds or thousands of meters, something's wrong. If you're getting values that are a tiny fraction of a meter, something is wrong. I always select something so that it will come out in a reasonable number of meters. So if you're getting something else, you'd want to go back and recheck your calculations because something is very off in them. So let's finish up here with a quick summary. And what we find is just kind of a quick review here. What we do, your first step in any of these is to calculate the scale factor based on the actual size of the object and the size you want to scale it to. All you do is divide these two. So you get the size that you want to scale it to. I give you that in the assignment. You look up the actual size of the object. In your case, it will be the sun. And then all you have to do is multiply that scale factor once you've determined it. It does not change. It's the same for the entire assignment by any other sizes or distances that you want to use. In this case, I do not ask you to do sizes for this assignment. You only need to do the distances from each of the planets to the sun and convert those to the scale. That will your scale factor will naturally give you that in centimeters. Divide your value by 100 to get it in meters, and you're all set. So I hope this has given a little bit of information on working through the project to calculate the scale of the solar system. Until next time, have a great day, everyone. And I will see you in class.